Welcome to Worship at Murrayfield UF Online on YouTube. My name is John Cross and I wish you a happy Boxing Day, if indeed that is a proper greeting that we give one another these days. The day after Christmas can be a bit of an anticlimax for many people, following the big build-up and then Christmas Day itself. Although, obviously, not for those people who have big family gatherings on Boxing Day. The church these days has a major focus on Advent, the weeks leading up to Christmas, and then, of course, the birth of the Saviour himself, of whom we'll now sing in Joy to the World. Let's join together in prayer. Let's all pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for Christmas Day and for the gift of your Son Jesus into the world. We thank you for time spent with family and friends, for good food and thoughtful presents. And yet we know that for some, it was a day of tension, difficult relationships, loneliness, or thoughts dominated by the empty chair where a loved one used to sit. Whatever yesterday was like for us, even our best days are in need of your grace, and none of our worst days are beyond the reach of your grace. And so we come to you today to worship the King who brought joy to the world. Forgive us for the times we have not given you your rightful place in our hearts and lives. Help us day by day to be more aware of the wonders of your love demonstrated most clearly in the person of Jesus, in whose name we pray. Amen. Our reading today is actually two readings from the same passage, but from different translations. Firstly, from the Good News Bible, which is a version I've always used, and then from the King James Version, which I know many people are familiar with. The readings are from Luke chapter 2, verses 16 to 20.
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and saw the baby lying in the manger. When the shepherds saw him, they told them what the angel had said about the child. All who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said. Mary remembered all these things and thought deeply about them. The shepherds went back, singing praises to God for all they had heard and seen. It had been just as the angel had told them. And now from the King James Version. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, as it was told unto them.
Many of you of a similar age to me, I'm sure, will be familiar with being unable to remember useful things like where you left your keys or your glasses, or who you spoke to at the shops yesterday, but still be able to recall all sorts of useful trivia from your childhood or youth. One such piece of trivia came into my mind this past week. It's the name of the ranch in the 1960s Western series Bonanza. I wonder if any of you remember. It was called the Ponderosa. I thought it was a great name. A place where one could ponder the great things of life. Are you a ponderer? I want to suggest that the days after Christmas are a good time to ponder. Advent is a time for waiting. Christmas, a time for celebrating. Now is the time for pondering, to contemplate, to consider, to reflect, to mull over, to examine, and to evaluate. But it's not just an exercise of the mind. Luke tells us that Mary pondered all these things in her heart. Now, I've asked a few folk to help us think about pondering today. First, here is Bruce Davis explaining how reflecting on something he wished he'd never said led to him writing this song for the season.
How many times have we heard that this year is going to be different for Christmas? Well, I wonder, will we still get caught up in the busyness of Christmas so much that we sometimes lose sight of what the reality of Christmas actually is? Many years ago, before I became a professional performer, I worked in John Mingus, one of the great Scottish institutions. And it was the run-up to Christmas, and it was very, very busy. And I found myself saying something, and I was absolutely appalled that I'd said it. But I found myself saying, thank goodness it happens just once a year. There I was, a Christian, but I'd lost sight of the reason for Christmas and was all caught up in the busyness and business of Christmas. And I ended up writing this song, and every year I sing it whenever Christmas begins to appear in the shops, and sometimes that's August, but I just like to be reminded of what Christmas is really about. Fancy lights, busy streets, crowds everywhere. Christmas is coming, the snow in the air. Party time, bells that chime, a time of good cheer. Thank goodness it happens just once a year. Is this your Christmas? Is this what you know? A song for the season, tickets for the show. A sock full of presents, cans in the bin, still no room at the inn. We could feel as Mary felt when she had God inside. Would we feel really humble and fill up with pride? Well, we can feel just as she did. He's inside us now and waiting to grow if we'll only allow. But what is your Christmas? What will you know? A song for the season, tickets for the show, a sock full of presents, cans in the bin, still no room at the inn. Can't you hear a voice calling? You've heard it before. Come in from the darkness to light evermore. Take the message of Christmas, don't miss it again. He's the way, the truth, the life for all men. Enjoy your Christmas, enjoy all you've got, but please don't forget to give Jesus a thought. It was cold in the stable. Is he waiting there still? Let him into your Christmas, if you will. So what is your Christmas? What will you know? A song for the season, tickets for the show, a sock full of presents, cans in the bin, still no room at the inn.
Two of our most faithful YouTube watchers are Elise Smith, formerly Elise Adeney from First Crescent in Bannockburn, and her son Alan, who have lived in Stockport for many years. I asked Elise to share her memories of Christmases in Bannockburn in days gone by.
Over the years, I have many very happy memories of growing up in the church, from being 5 or 6 in the upstairs Sunday school in the old church building, to being in Mr. Porter's Bible class, and we met in the vestry. The Christmas services were very special. There was the one when Miss Henderson told her lovely version of the Christmas story of God's miracle in the stable in Bethlehem. Alan found it on the church website and we always enjoy listening to it every year. Then there was the watch night service when you felt very grown up to be allowed to attend. The singing was amazing. There were always 2 trees, one on either side of the pulpit, and one year Mr. Palmer had us collecting sprigs of holly which he attached to lengths of rope and they were looped between the pillars in the old church. The Christmas parties were always a joy. I remember being given a paper bag, I think it was during the war at that time, with a sausage roll and other bits and buns. Santa, of course, was there and there were always lots of fun and games. One year my mother became unwell a few weeks before Christmas and I was in Bannockburn with the boys looking after her. On Sunday, the boys were delighted to be called to the front of the Sunday school and given a present from Miss Henderson. They still remember that even now. The next day, there was a very heavy fall of snow and the boys found my brother's old sledge in the shed and spent hours going up and down the steep hill in the park. They didn't even notice the cold. Happy days. I remember reading somewhere that God gives us our fondest memories so that we can have roses in December. In the darkest days of winter, to be able to recall our favourite heartwarming moments.
Let's join together again in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for our roses in December. The memories we have of the excitement of Christmas as a child. The memories of those who made Christmas special for us, but are no longer with us. We thank you for the shared memories we have with others in this community and congregation, for things that have been brought to mind by Elise's words. We thank you for the person who first made the coming of Jesus so real to us. For many in Murrayfield, it was Miss Henderson. But whoever it was, we give you thanks for that person's faithful witness. And as we remember, we give you thanks for the gift of memory itself. And we bring before you those who have lost that gift and are unable to remember even their loved ones. We pray for those who care for people with dementia in its various forms, whether at home or in care homes. Give them patience, understanding, and love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Did you ever wonder how much Mary really knew about the baby she had given birth to? Well, that's the subject of our next hymn, which is called Mary, Did You Know?
Did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new?
Mary.
Joan Martin grew up in Murrayfield Church, and I'm sure her memories will be memories that many of you share, although I don't suppose many of you will have seen her dressed as an angel like this before. This was Joan when the children from Bannockburn Primary came to visit the church a couple of Christmases ago. But here are her memories of Christmases gone by.
Christmas at Murrayfield was always a joyful and happy time. How we loved singing the old familiar carols and hearing Miss Henderson tell of the first Christmas when the world received the first and best Christmas present, God's Son, Jesus. The wee ones then sang Away in a Manger, always a heart-touching moment. The Bible readings were from the King James Version, where we heard how the shepherds were sore afraid, until the angel told them, "Fear not." Most of all, I listened for Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. How human. The church was always beautifully decorated with fairy lights round the balcony and holly on the pillars. On the windowsill behind the pulpit, there were decorated trees, while on the wall was a picture of Mary, Joseph, and of course, the little grey donkey. The watch night service and the singing of Silent Night at midnight added the final special touch to what truly was and still is a magical, wonderful day.
Did you hear the emotion in Joan's voice there? Reflecting on the past can be quite an emotional experience, particularly just now, when we're unable to celebrate Christmas in our church building. And I really appreciate Joan and Elise being prepared to share their memories so publicly. It's interesting that Joan highlighted the verse, "Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart." I didn't tell her that we would be focusing on that verse today. They both mention the decorations in the church and Jenny Henderson's retelling of the Christmas story, which you can still find on the church website. I wonder how many times she told it over the years and how many times you heard it. There is a lot of repetition at Christmas, but as C.S. Lewis, the writer, said, we don't need to be told new ideas as much as we need to be reminded of old truths. I find the last week of the year a good time to ponder and reflect on days gone by. But it's important that it doesn't just become a time to wallow in nostalgia, but is a time to reassess our priorities and prayerfully consider the road ahead. Now, it's not just following Mary's example, but more importantly, the example of Jesus, who often went off alone to commune with his heavenly Father before resuming his mission. Of course, it's vital that our reflection and prayer and pondering is not a permanent state, but a precursor to us resuming our mission in life. Some of us, I know, are more reflective than others. And it's worth noting from the Bible passage that While Mary's response to Jesus' birth and the shepherd's visit was to ponder, the shepherds went back singing praises to God for all they had heard and seen. Perhaps we can learn from both of them. May our response be to ponder and praise in equal or perhaps unequal measure. Our final hymn is probably the first Christmas carol that we all learned as young children, Away in a Manger. Thanks to you all for joining us today, and thank you to Joan, Elise, Bruce, Gary and Alison for the parts they have played in our worship this morning. We'll be back next week at the same time on Murrayfield UF Online with the Reverend Gary Barclay back in charge. And now a blessing. May the love of God the Father, the peace of the Christ child, and the joy of the Holy Spirit bring us hope today and every day. Amen.